So you all can keep yourselves on mute, and whenever you all have any questions, you all can just simply unmute yourself and ask the question. First of all, let me just start the recording. Okay. So we'll be starting with a very introduction. The first half an hour, 40 minutes will be a basic introduction. You all can make your pointers if you all want to. I'll share the PPT. So that's not an issue at all. Also, after that, we'll start solving one paper. We'll see as to how the CP2 actually is, and then we'll take a few classes. I hope everyone have already done the prerequisite classes, the Excel classes, which I have shared with you all. If not, not an issue at all today for today, but I will suggest that you all should go through the prerequisite classes of Excel, which I have shared. So I might have shared with you all. So we'll be starting with a very basic introduction. Let me share my screen. So is my screen visible?
Yes, yes.
Okay. Okay.
Just one thing about the prerequisite classes, the YouTube classes were working, but the other classes like the GoalSeek and all those videos, because they were .wmv functions, they were not working on laptop. I mean, do you require any other software or something for those classes?
No, you'll have to make the password for those classes. Those are encrypted classes. So you'll have to make the password for that. I'll let you all know what is the issue. You all have to basically make the password for that. Is it fine, Adarsh?
Yeah, yeah. I need the password because that is why I did not have the player. I had the file, but not the player.
Okay. So today I'll again share the player and everything as to how you can make the password. And so that you can proceed, okay? Not an issue at all. I'll share the details today. Okay. So CP2, which is modeling practice. We'll be focusing the paper from IEI and IFOA. The structure is same, but the way of presentation is a little different in both the institutes. Also, the way they conduct the exam is a little different. Okay. Now, introduction. Basically, CP2, the name came in 2019 when the syllabus changed from CA2 to CP2. So the paper was same. The paper pattern remains the same. Also, prior to 2015, there was only one paper of CP2. Now you all have two papers. Basically, you have to sit for the two papers, paper one and paper two for CP2. Although you all can practice those papers from 2016 onwards till 2020, you all can practice both the IFOA and IA papers for your examinations, correct? Now, coming to what are the main aims and objectives of CP2, the very first thing is, as the name suggests, modeling practice. You have to create a model from scratch. Okay, now CP2 and CP3, both of the papers are very underrated, as to we think that we do not have to study much for these kind of papers and we can easily pass these papers. But the fact is, it requires a lot of time. At the same time, a lot of smart work is also required in order to clear these two papers. Although it might seem easy when you start studying, but when you study, when you see the papers and you go through the different papers, you will realize that it is not very easy to pass. You have to manage your time very well, which is a very important factor in case of CP2 examinations. Secondly, you need to make certain tips and tricks for yourself so that you can complete the paper on time and also you can score well. So it is not very simple as it seems from outside. When you do it, you will realize that, okay, it is not that simple. Okay. So next we have the objective. The basic objective of the paper, both the paper, paper one and paper two. So the paper is to create a model from scratch. Now, paper one, this is for paper one. In paper one, we create a model from scratch and then we present it in the form of, we write an audit trail what is an audit trail, I'll talk about that. So we have to present what we have created as a model to our senior actuary as well as our colleague actuary. Okay. Now basically it will, you have to use your judgment. You have to use your own assumptions, make your own assumptions while creating these models. Now the basic six aims for this examination CP2 is first three, which you see, are for paper one. Last three are generally for paper two. Now the first three, which says that you have to prepare and summarize the data and undertake exploratory data analysis and visualization. Basically, you will be given a data. Like, suppose when I say data, suppose you have been given scores of certain students from different schools. So this is a data which has been given to you. Or maybe you have been given a sales data of a particular company for a period of time. And the cost and the variable cost, fixed costs are also there. Then the profit, you have to take out how the profit changes and all of that. So these are the data which has been given to you. First of all, you have to summarize these data. What do I mean by summarizing? There are five basic summaries which we can be, which we'll always calculate: minimum, maximum, count, average, and standard deviation. So these are the summary statistics which we have to calculate. And then, very important portion, we have to check whether the data is correct or not. We have to validate the data. Okay. So if the data is given, suppose uniform, from uniform distribution 0 to 1. Now, if I say it is given from uniform distribution 0 to 1, it cannot be less than 0, it cannot be more than 1, right? The data. But it might so happen that the data collection team might have made a certain mistake and you might have certain data which are greater than 1, which is less than 0. So you have to validate your data. You have to visualize your data. This means, suppose if I say that this particular data which I have follows uniform 0, 1. Now, you what can you do as per your previous knowledge? You can create a chi-square test. We can see that these are the actual data which is given to us. This should be the expected, and we can calculate the chi-square test statistics. Also, we can create a graph. We can create a histogram out of expected and actual data. Now, if I say the data belongs to a normal distribution, so again, you can plot it and you can see whether it is actually following the normal distribution or not. Second, it is asking us to calculate an actuarial model to solve a realistic problem. Now, these realistic problems, sometimes it might seem easy to you, sometimes it might not seem easy to you. And if it so happens that it is seeming easy to you, but actually it is not. Okay, the question and the crux of the question, what it is asking, you may not get the question at the first read always. Now, these realistic problems can be any problem. It is not always generally from the financial aspect. It can be any problem. So as I said, it can be scores of students from different schools, or it can be like today, the paper which we are going to solve. It is basically the points which has been given by the national shooting team to us. So these are the different problems which will be given to us, and you have to create the model from scratch. From scratch meaning nothing else will be given, only the questions will be there and only the data will be there. You have to create your own kind of a model. Now that depends on you, how you create your model, correct? Document the model by constructing an audit trail. Now, what is an audit trail? This is with respect to paper one. You have to create an audit trail for paper one. Now, what is an audit trail? Suppose we have made a model in the spreadsheet. Okay, we have to create the model in the spreadsheet in the Excel file. Now, whatever you have done in the Excel file needs to be presented in the Word file in case of IFOA. In case of IAI, you have to present it within the Excel file only. So may I know, all the three of you, are you guys appearing from IA or IFOA?
I am appearing from IFOA.
Okay.
I'm appearing from IFOA.
Okay, so all of us are from IFOA. Still, no, we will be solving IA paper as well. So basically, you have to present an audit trail. In order to train, you have to say that, okay, in this particular cell, in this particular column, we have done this calculation. Why we have done this kind of calculation? What is, so it will start this way. First, you have to mention the statement of purpose and statement of purpose of creating the model, basically. Then your data. And that data, in that data section, the source of data. What is the sources of data? You have got it from the statistics team. You have everything will be mentioned in your question paper. You have to write it in your word file. Why I'm saying, I will come to that. And then what validation tests you have carried out on data, any checks, any changes which you have made on your data. These are the things. Then we write the assumptions. Now, these assumptions are the assumptions which we make. There might be certain assumptions which might be written and given in our model, but basically you will have to give your own assumptions. Okay. Then we have the method. Now in this method section, we give all the point wise or sheet wise, tab wise, different sheets in our Excel sheet, how we have done our each work. So this two things, creating the model and then also creating an audit trail, both the things should be done in 3 hours 15 minutes time only. And when I say audit trail, it must be, and generally it is between 6 to 7 pages, okay, of the word file. Moving on, analyze the method used and outputs generated. So basically in the second paper, what happens that a model is already given to us, an audit trail is also given to us, and some of the model has already been done by our colleague. Okay, and then we have to just complete that particular model. So maybe another 15 marks will be given just to complete the rest of the questions, 2-3 questions which are left. And then you have to make a summary report. So communicate the results, apply and interpret the results, communicate the results. This is basically, you have to create a summary for your senior actuary as to how the model has been made, what is the method, again the data, the assumptions, and then the main part is the results and conclusion. So what are the results which have been obtained along each of the process, along each of the parts of the model, and how do you interpret these results, what are the conclusions which you make, and then the lastly we say something called, we write something called next steps. I will come to that. So you can understand the summary report which we write in paper 2 is of around 8 to 10 pages, it will depend. And again, so it is very time consuming because you have to type a lot, and you just not have to type, you have to think and then you have to type, correct? So it becomes a little time consuming, although I have generally seen this, that paper 1 is lengthier than paper 2. So we will come to that, why is it so? So the exam will be conducted on 2 consecutive days. Day 1 will be your 3 hours 15 minutes. Day 2 again 3 hours 15 minutes. 2 consecutive days in case of IFOA. In case of IA, it is on one day itself. First 3 hours 15 minutes will be paper 1, and then maybe you will be given an 1.5 hours and time, and then after that we'll be having the paper 2 examination. Okay. Now the next thing is, both the paper will have different models, so you will not get the same model. Paper 1 is a completely different model, paper 2 is completely different model you have to work on. So you will be working on 2 different models on 2 different days. In some cases, for paper 1, additional guidance will be given as to suppose how to conduct the chi-square test. Okay, this generally will not be given because they assume that we all know how to do that. But sometimes they might give it as an additional guidance. So we can follow that, we can use that additional guidance which is there in the question paper to answer. Okay, so that is not an issue. It covers certain technical aspects, okay, certain formulas, certain functions which is new to us, because we'll be working in different domains. Someone is working in a life insurance, someone is working in a general insurance, and when they get a paper, suppose a life insurance person, they get a paper of a general insurance, so they might not calculate all the technical aspects. So additional guidance is given. You can or you cannot follow it, it's up to you. Okay, Now the paper one format will be as I have discussed already. You will be given with a model, you will be given with a realistic problem basically, and you have to create a model for it from scratch. You have to then present your model in your audit trail. Now when I talk about this audit trail, when you are making the audit trail, we need to consider two people basically. One is the fellow student and a senior actually. So when I am making the audit trail, I should keep in mind that someone who is of my level, of my experience, of my knowledge, that person will also be reading my audit trail and making changes to that. Also, it will be going to the senior actually, who will be correcting my model. Correct. Then we should assume, so here, as I said, the fellow student will be of our same knowledge, and the senior actually, he will be seeing what are the different actuarial methods, aspects we have used, technical assumptions which we have made. Okay, they do not need much of the Excel details and functions because they already know that. They just concentrate on how and what we have done. Now the paper two format, a model will be given to us. Our audit trail will be given to us, already made by our colleague, and some of the model will be already made. What we have to do is we have to understand first the problem, the realistic problem which is given. Then we have to understand the model which has already been made by the colleague. Okay, because this model you are not creating. This model is already made by your colleague. So you need to understand as to what is the model, how is the model made, by reading the audit trail. So continuously you will be reading the audit trail and you will be seeing the spreadsheet. So in paper two, what happens, we'll be given with the audit trail as well as we'll be given with the spreadsheet and the question paper. So we have to go through the spreadsheet along with the audit trail to see that what and how, which kind of model has been made, try to understand that model and then build up on that model. You have to not make any changes to that model. If you think that this particular portion is wrong, they will never ask you to change the model in paper two. They will only ask you to complete the rest of the portion. So never try to change the model two, model which has been given in paper two, sorry. So generally this point will be mentioned in your question paper, that you do not have to change anything in the model. You just have to build upon it. So you do not have to make any changes. You assume that whatever has been done is correct. Because at the end, always understand this thing that CP2 is not always about creating the model. Correct. Because when we come to the marks weightage, we'll see that it is mostly about communicating and trying to understand the realistic problem which has been given and solve it according to your own way. Because if we are four of us over here and we've been given with a problem, all four of us can solve it, the same problem, we'll be getting the same answer but in different ways. Correct. So no one way is always correct. So they are not bothered as to always bothered as to how you have done. Yes, they will see your steps in all of these things. But if you have made one assumption, suppose Adarsh has made one assumption, he has taken one particular variable or parameter constant. You have to mention that in the assumption section that I've taken this as constant and why you have taken it as constant. And then I have built upon my model using this particular assumption. So all is on your assumption which you create, and then you have to just build upon the model. There is no eligibility requirements. So this is a very prominent question which every one of us might be thinking, that do we need to complete or pass any clear any previous CT series paper? Not always the case. Yes, you might get some of the questions, and these questions might be a little bit related to these subjects. So if you have already studied these subjects, you might be more easily making the model, but this is like just 5 or 10% of it. You have to practice a lot, and if you know the tips and tricks as to how and what are the things, how we can make a model, those steps, if you know, you can easily construct the model. Then it doesn't matter that you have given these papers or not. Obviously it will give you an advantage, but not always, as I said. Okay. Now, obviously, you will not be required, you will not be permitted to use any pre-prepared file. So suppose this, most of us we think that okay, we can prepare a Word file. We can write the some common assumptions. We can write some common next steps which we do in the paper two. I will come to that. So these are the things which we think that okay, we can create this beforehand and we can just copy paste. Please do not do this. They will understand that okay, you have copy pasted from some other document. So this is exact. This is prohibited in case of IFOA. And then we have the prerequisites. So there are two prerequisites. First is Excel. You should know the basic functions of Excel. Okay, so when I talk about basic functions of Excel, what some of us do is when we create a model, we use some very hi-fi functions. Okay, this is not what they want. Generally, please avoid using pivot tables. So we'll be solving a lot of models, and over the time, we'll realize that we do not always have to use those hi-fi functions. And when I say hi-fi functions, these functions might be easy for us, and obviously for the senior actuary, and obviously for the examiner. But still, the do not want us to use these functions. Like I have written some if over here, correct? They do not want you to use some ifs. You can use some ifs function, but you can also avoid using it, and you can solve it in your own way without the use of some ifs. Now there are other functions like frequency function. So this function you might use, but also there are places that you can avoid using count frequency, and instead of that you can use COUNTIF function. So wherever you think that you can simplify your work, always and always simplify your work. Do not use these hi-fi features, do not use pivot tables. Your marks will be deducted for that. Okay, then we have, so these are the basics of Excel which we have to do. I've already sent across the prerequisite videos. And then we have the basics of MS Word. So basically in this, not much of it is required. Just you need to know how to create a table in your Word file and how to insert graph from your spreadsheet into your Word file. That's it. So nothing much of Word is required. Okay, so these are the basic pointers which I have made for you all. It might not seem very nice at this point because you haven't already started making the model, but I'll send the PPT across so you all can come to these points again. Basically, the approach should be very simple. As I said, it should be easy to change. When I'm saying easy to change, there are certain parameters. So there is a difference between the input, you can say, and the parameter. Now, what is the difference between the two? See, one is the data which has been given to us, okay, and the other things are the parameters. Now, what are these parameters? These parameters are the things which keep on changing. These are the variable things which you can change. Suppose when I say interest rate, so interest rate is the parameter which can be changed. So these parameters should not be hard-coded. And what do I mean by hard-coded? You just cannot write interest rate and then you write 6%. You are typing 6% there, and whenever you are doing any calculation, further calculation, you're simply typing 6% in place of interest rate. You should not do that. Instead, you should make a parameter sheet. We'll understand how to do that. We have to make a parameter sheet. In that, we have to give all the parameters which are there in our model. And it is sometimes better that we rename these cells. Why we rename? We'll also understand the shortcut. We'll also learn the shortcut of renaming. So it will be just done in 1 second. Once you rename your cell, then you can use it in all your sheets easily. You don't have to again and again go back to your parameter sheet. Okay. Separate your inputs, calculation, and results. So as I said, there will be many tabs which we'll create on the spreadsheet. So we'll come to that. Always make sure your structure of the spreadsheet is from left to right, top to bottom. Do not just mix and match things, because then it becomes difficult for the examiner and also for you to later on come and analyze the thing. Keep the formulas as simple as possible. As I said, do not use such hi-fi formulas which are not required. Also, these are the points. Avoid manual intervention. So as I said, if you are hard coding the formula with interest rate of 6%, so you are typing 6%, instead of selecting a one particular cell, then the next person who comes in and who wants to make any changes to your model, and maybe that person is assuming the interest rate to be 7%, then that person has to literally change the 7% in all the cells wherever you have used the interest rate. So do not do that. Only in some of the cases we have to do the manual intervention, and wherever it is done, we'll always mention at the side that you have to change this particular input over here. So this, all these things, these small things needs to be kept in mind, because marks are deducted for these small things only. And then we are saying that in one particular column, so you give the formula at the very start, you write the formula, and then you just simply drag it down, correct? Now suppose what you have done is your formula changes in between, like after 1 year, something is changing in your formula. So you are making a change after maybe 5-6 cells. You have to flag it, in the sense you have to maybe change the color of it, or you add a comment over it on the cell that you have made a change. Otherwise, the examiner will just see the top cell and will give you the marks accordingly. So you have to keep these points in mind. Now obviously, how to pass an examination is always preparation is the key. In CP2, this becomes very essential, because all the models are different. So you cannot, it's not like you are studying a subject like CM1. It is not like that you have, you know the syllabus and you have practiced certain kind of questions and you're just producing that in the examination. Because you can get any kind of model in the examination. What is required is the preparation. Why preparation? Because only if you practice a lot, you will realize that, okay, these are the tips, these are the methods of how to proceed ahead. If I get stuck in between, this is how I can overcome, this is how I can reduce my time. Efficient use of time, believe me, this fourth point is the most important point. Because also with me, what happened in paper one was there was a time shortage. When I say time shortage, the model which came, because it is not always that you will get the model in the one read. So when I first read the entire model, I did not get the model completely. So I had to read it again. And in that process, what happened, I spent a lot of time in my spreadsheet, and I had a little time, like what accordingly I planned, that this way I will spend this much time on my spreadsheet, this much time on my audit trail. And what happened with me was that I ended up having less time from my audit trail. An audit trail is of 50, around 58, so you can consider 60 marks is for audit trail, and guest is for your model. So your model is not the important thing. Your audit trail is the important thing, which is 60% of your paper. Correct. So you have to give equal importance to even the audit trail, which many of us do not. What we do is we think that constructing the model is more important. We focus a lot of time on that, and at the end, we're left with only a few, maybe hours for the audit trail. So that should not be the case. Efficient use of time is especially for paper one, because paper one is sometimes a little lengthy. In cases where the models which is given to us, we might not get the model in the first read, or purposely the model has been kept a little long. Okay. Now, splitting of the time. So this is what the IFOA has given guidelines, but I personally do not follow it completely. What I follow is, I'll tell you all. So read the question. This is for paper one, where the real problem will be given to us and we have to create the model from scratch. So they say that reading 15 minutes. Now, I generally take more than 15 minutes to read, because I read it very slowly. And when I read it, I keep on marking the important points or important words which I feel that, okay, these are important points. You should keep a paper and pen with yourself so that when you are reading and you consider that, okay, this point I might forget, but I have to make a point of this. So you can simply scribble on your paper fast, okay? So reading might go up to 20 minutes. Do not take it more than that. Please, you have to, because if many of us, we do not have a habit of reading a lot. So we are slow readers, but try and improving your reading also. Because if you are reading very fast, you are at an advantage. Planning your paper. Now, what I do is I read and plan at the same time. Okay, so that's why my reading time increases a little. But again, you have to refer back to the questions again and again. So instead of that, you can say that reading up to 20 minutes and then rest, you can say 15 minutes for your planning, not more than that. Then modeling is 1.5 hours. So basically it is given 1.5 hours. But what I will suggest is keep 1 hour for modeling. At in your mind, because if you have kept a target of 1 hour for modeling, you might then increase it by 15 minutes. So that's fine. But if you have already kept a target of 1 hour 30 minutes, you might end up taking 1 hour 40 minutes, 45 minutes, which is not correct. Because audit trail is equally important. And why we have kept 1 hour? Because again, two things, as I said, your reading should be fast. Along with that, your typing should be really fast. Because if you type very fast, trust me, audit trail will be very easy for you. Because audit trail is easy. You just have to know how to present it. Easy in the sense, with practice, it will seem easy. But you need to type each and every paper. So you have to practice a lot. You just can't do the model and leave the audit trail. Okay, I've read it, so I know I can produce it in the exam. This is not the case. You have to type it down. So two things which you have to work: improve your reading time speed, basically, and secondly, improve your typing speed. So reading speed and typing speed, if these two are very good already, you are already at an advantage. If not, you should start practicing it from now. For paper two, again, the model will be given, audit trail will be given, spreadsheet will be given. So all of these things, first you have to study the problem, realistic problem. Then you have to see the model which is there in the spreadsheet along with the audit trail. So 15 minutes, it takes obviously more than 15 minutes. Sometimes it might take half an hour to complete all of these things, read all of these things, understand the model. And then spreadsheet work, 30 minutes. You can say that this is the maximum you should give, because the spreadsheet work will only be of 15 marks. Okay, not more than that. Rest 85 marks will be your summary. And so they have allotted 2 hours. You can take more than 2 hours if your typing speed is slow. You have to write around 8 to 10 pages. So you can understand the amount of typing you have to do in summary. And in summary, you have to think also when you type, because you have to think about the result, how to present it, how to interpret it, all of these things. So we'll do a lot of papers, so I'll be talking about it more in future as to how much time you have to give. Now modeling paper one, keep it simple, as I said. Now there is something called checks. So we'll be studying, there are two things. One is self-check, one is reasonableness check. Now, what is self-check? Self-check is, suppose, it is written over here, reasonableness check, and one is your self-check. Self-check is basically, you are doing a calculation, and the entire row, entire column should add up to maybe 5,000. So, below that, you are creating a check that, okay, this is adding up to 5,000, so my output is correct. This is your self-check, which you are doing. Suppose you're performing a goal seek. So in the goal seek, your output should match a particular target which is given to us in the question maybe. And if your target is matching, if your output is matching to the target, then your entire calculation is correct. These are the self-check, and we are giving with around 5 to 6 marks on the self-check. So my spreadsheet, when I'm creating the spreadsheet, each sheet must contain one or two self-check. In total, your aim should be to, in total, make at least 5 to 7 self-check. More than 5, at least 6-7 self-check should be there. Now, next is reasonableness check. Now, what is reasonableness check? This is basically your output is correct or not. It is coming as per what you or the model wants. Suppose your interest rate cannot be negative, correct? So if it is coming negative, then you have to make a comment on it that it is coming negative. This might be the reason. It is coming positive, hence it is correct. So these are the things, reasonableness check and self-check. Self-check should be there in your spreadsheet, as well as you have to mention one line on it in your audit trail. Reasonableness check is generally mentioned in your audit trail that my output was this, and it is reasonable to assume that, okay, it is reasonable, the output was reasonable, and the line goes on that why it is reasonable. In case of audit trail, you do not have to analyze your output. Whatever output we are getting, you do not have to conclude or interpret it. That is for the paper two. Paper one is only what you have done in the model, produce it on your audit trail, correct? Now next we have, okay, so these are the things which should be there. So I said auto checks are nothing but the self check and the reasonableness check, and you have to consider that there are two audiences to whom you have to refer the audit trail. Now, in case of audit trail, we have the assumptions, all the steps and the methods which we have followed, and the reason for our decision. Basically, this is also covered in the assumption section. Now, in case of paper two is for the senior actuary. Okay, so in this paper, you have to give the purpose of creating the summary. Basically, what is your model's purpose, or what is your realistic problem which has been given to you, the data, everything, the validation and everything, assumptions, and then the method. So method, which is covered in audit trail in your paper one, is very big. You go cell by cell, you go column by column. In paper two, your method is only maybe of 1.5 page, in which you give the complete method of a model. Remember, in paper two, we have been given with the audit trail. Do not copy paste from the audit trail to your summary directly. What I do is, actually, I'm just sharing my secret, but I generally avoided the reading of audit trail in paper two. So in paper two, we get the model. In the spreadsheet, built up model already, and a audit trail. Generally, what I did when I was practicing is that I skipped the audit trail portion in paper two, because audit trail is nothing but what is there in a spreadsheet. So if you can understand the spreadsheet directly, why we should go and read the audit trail? But again, this is what I did. But in some papers, obviously, I had to refer to audit trail. You should read the audit trail for your first few papers. If you see that, okay, without reading the audit trail also, you can understand the model, then that's the best thing, because you're saving time at the end. So do not ever copy paste from the audit trail directly to the summary. And here the most important is these two points. You have to give the results and conclusions and comment on the results. This is the marking of both the papers. It is compulsory that you have to sit for both the papers. Even if you do not, if you skip any one paper, you will be marked absent and they will not check your paper. Secondly, they give 50-50% weightage to both the papers. So suppose in paper one I'm scoring 80, so they will consider it as 40, and in paper one I'm scoring maybe, paper two I'm scoring maybe 70, so they will take it as 35. So 40 plus 35. That is how they mark. So these are the just weightage. These are adding up to 50%. So obviously you can double this to get 100% weightage. Audit trail, content of audit trail. So this is itself making around 58, I think. 20 plus 38, 58. So you can understand there are 60% weightage given to your audit trail. And then self-check is your 6 marks. Preparation, data analysis, data preparation is your, again, 6 marks. And rest 30 is your spreadsheet. So again, your 40 marks is for the spreadsheet portion completely. Here, this is the paper two. In paper two, this entire portion is your summary. Summary description, summary results, summary conclusion, next steps, and summary drafting. So you can see more than 80% is for summary, and only 12 to 15% weightage will be given to your spreadsheet. That is nothing but you're completing the existing model. These are the approaches. I will not go into details of it. We'll come to it once we are solving the papers. These are the content which we have to mention in the audit trail. I will come to it. I will not bore you guys with all of these now. These are the content of the summary, which should be there. Conclusion and results. So results and conclusion together is of 30 marks. So you can understand the weightage of analyzing the results. So it is not that you have just produced something, you have to analyze it, you have to understand it, interpret it, the results which you have got. And then the next steps is of 20 marks again. What are these next steps? Next steps is, suppose whenever there's a model which has been created, you have certain assumptions on it. So these assumptions may not always hold true in real life. So in next steps, we write, how can you improve the model? You can validate the data more. You can check the information from some other source. So these are the basic pointers which I've written. This is of 20 marks. So at least you have to write 20 to 25 points in your next steps. Actually, these next steps, there are many of the common next steps which you can extract. I will share the file also with you all. Using which, these are the common next steps which are present in all your models. You just have to modify it. Suppose when we talk about sensitivity analysis, what is it? Suppose interest rate is 6%, sensitivity analysis is 1% change in your parameter. Then we have stress testing. Stress testing is more than 40%, 50% change in your parameters, correct? So these are stochastic models. So these are the different ways in which you can improve the model. Next step is basically saying how you can improve your model. Peer review, getting a peer review, all of those points. Last slide. So the most important thing is when you are working, in every 15 minutes, save your work, control S, because this is the most important thing. And seriously, when maybe there might be a certain technical glitch and maybe your laptop shuts down, your work is not saved, that is the worst thing that can happen to us. So it is very important that in every 15 minutes we have to save our work. Okay, this has to be inculcated when we practice in our classes. We'll be continuously saving. If it is inculcated from the very first day, you will follow it in your examination as well. So this was my entire introduction. I hope I haven't bored you all. What you all can do is ask me a few questions if you want. I'll give you a 5 minutes break after that, and we'll come back. We'll discuss the April 2020 paper, first paper. We'll be reading the model, we'll be talking about it, and then we'll start maybe with the first question, and tomorrow we'll come across it. Okay, so if you all have any doubts, you all can ask me. Any doubts, it can be anything. So that is why we are keeping the classes on Google Meet, so that it can be very interactive with us. Anything you want to ask?
Harshvandi, am I audible?
Yeah, you're audible, Siddhi.
I just have one question. Like for Excel, you said that pivot shouldn't be used, right? Like hi-fi formulas and everything. But what if I'm very comfortable with all these things? For example, for me, when I'm working on Excel, so I always use pivot because it's very handy for me and I don't have to write the formulas every time. And again, you said that if I use pivot, there will be a deduction in the marks, right? So what is the best scenario with that? Because since I've been working, so I'm very comfortable, but I'm not sure how it will be developing through exams.
Actually, Siddhi, that is why I have mentioned this, because I know people who used pivot table, but the marks got deducted, they did not get the full marks. Do not use it. Even they have mentioned it to keep it very, very simple. I've also given a list of functions. You can use more functions, extra functions, like I said, some if. Now, they even have avoided using some ifs. So you can just think that even this simple function when they have avoided, so they will not accept your pivot table. Why, Siddhi, why this happens is because, when we talk about sorting the data, correct? When we have to sort the data, I haven't seen anywhere that they have used sorting and filtering. So even this basic feature they avoid, because these features, they might end up changing your data, the actual data. Because if you have sorted your data in a particular manner, you might lose the original data. Although you have put it in separate sheet, that is also there. But still, we have to avoid these, because at the end, obviously, we want to clear the examination. These are only the basic things which the marks get deducted. Although these are the things which makes easy. Makes our work very simple. The examiner also understands, but they consider that these are the bad practicing models, modeling habits. We should not use sorting and filtering a lot. We should not use pivot tables. We should not use difficult functions. Some product you might get some places, but there were places where I was using these functions, and when I saw the solution was very simple. They have done it in a very simple. It takes a little bit extra time, no doubt, obviously. But again, yes, you should avoid these. And pivot tables, though, you cannot use at all, because that is the thing which they have avoided everywhere. Pivot table should always be avoided, because at the end you have to submit your sheets, and also I think there might be certain changes which happen when the examiner, and there are two examiners who will check your paper. So you know how the way they interpret things will get a little difficult. And also one thing, this is a very interesting thing, that even I was thinking that if we can, why are we not allowed to use these functions? Because actually the main reason is we have to make an audit trail. Correct. And when you're using pivot tables, when you're using these difficult functions, and when you are using these difficult functions, and then you're writing the audit trail, it becomes difficult. Because you have to explain something which is difficult. Correct. When you're explaining a pivot table, and when you're explaining a normal function, just consider that explaining a normal function will be anytime easier. And your audit trail consists of 60%. So these are that is why they have kept the things very simple. So construct the model as simply as possible. Distribute the calculation. Do not only perform it in one cell. Because if we think that, okay, it will save our time, but at the end, we are losing the points there. Okay. Any other question?
Sorry, one more question. So as you said, that the model should be very simple. For example, some formulas may be simple for you, but it may be tougher for me. In a similar way, there may be few formulas or check-ins that is very simpler for me and may be tougher for the other person. So how will I know that, okay, this formula is way easier for the audit person? Like, is there any prerequisite by IF mentioned that, okay, this is something that you should use and this is something that you are not allowed to use during the exam?
So, as I've made the list of all the functions which I have come across so far, these are the only functions which we should use. I've already made and I've already put it in the PPT. Try and keep yourselves within these functions only. And as I said, when we are making audit trail, we should keep in mind two things. Senior actually obviously has more knowledge, and one is our colleague who has the exact same knowledge as of ours. So you have to think, okay, if I know this, my colleague will also know this. So that's not an issue at all. But the functions, okay, this becomes a little trickier when we think, okay, we should use this function or not. But I have made the entire list of all the functions which I came across, and these are the only functions. This is a complete list which I have made. Keep yourself within these functions only. If we find any function extra, we might add it on to this list, but we should keep it within. I've added it in my slide, in my prerequisite slide. So I'll be sharing the PPT. These are the basic functions, sum, count, and you know, we'll be using these basic functions only. The main task over here is to understand the question given to us and then to present the model in a simple manner. So this becomes a little, you know, a task over here. Any other question?
How many times do they refer to the past subjects? I mean, I was looking at some of the papers, but the model was not that related to CM1, CM2. Like, they were in itself data analysis more than actuarial subjects. So how many times have they referred?
Yeah, so that is what I said. Not always they will refer. In fact, they will never in their paper mention CM1 or CM2 explicitly. There will be times when you will have to, like, there was one model on stochastic rates. So that is there in your CM2, correct? If you have done CM2, which is you have done the Excel portion, you will be more accustomed with how to solve it. If you have done CT8 portion, so you will not be more accustomed on how to solve it in Excel. So that is only the place where, and when we talk about CM1, so in CM1 we have loan schedule, correct? So that is there, you'll get a model on loans, suppose. So that gives you an advantage that, okay, if you know CM1, you know how to construct a loan schedule. Others, they might put in extra columns and all of that, but you exactly know that what are the columns which should be there in a loan schedule. So that is only the place where you get an advantage a little bit. They will never mention directly that, okay, this is from CMN. And wherever they think that, okay, this should be the extra guidance which needs to be given to the all the students, they will give an additional guidance on the technical knowledge at the very end. So that is not an issue at all. You have to understand the model and you have to produce it on your spreadsheet. That is the main thing over here. So I think there is no more question. I please download April 2020 paper 1. Today we'll be just going through the model. I'll give a 5 minutes break. So we'll be coming back exactly at 7:05. Okay. We'll be coming back at 7:05. Is that fine for all? Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Okay. Thank you. Can we start?
Yes.
Okay. So what you all can do is, you all can also open the question paper along with me. Split the screen into two so that you all can also read. I'll be sharing my screen. Okay, so this is the April 2020 paper, paper one. We'll read everything which is there in the paper. So firstly, these are the questions, exam requirements. These are the questions, modeling steps and data checks. Read the background document that describes the scenario that needs to be modeled and documented for this project. So the scenario has been given. The background document is nothing but the scenario or the realistic problem which has been given to us. Construct a spreadsheet model that produces the following calculation and charts. You should ensure that your spreadsheet contains appropriate self-checks, as I said, that you have performed robust reasonableness checks. So self-check and reasonableness checks are very important at each stage of your calculation. Now, these are the questions. I'll avoid reading it at the first. So you will not go through these questions now because obviously you will not understand once you have read the background document. So we can avoid these questions. See, this is of 30 marks in total. So whatever you do on your spreadsheet is of 30 marks. All scenarios outlined above, so this we are going to read later when we have read the entire background document. Modeling technique and practice. So this is nothing but the marks, 12 marks, extra 12 marks given for the techniques and the demonstration of good modeling techniques and practice. Over here comes your functions which you have used, the way you have presented your model, left to right, top to bottom, flagging, whether you have used the parameters, you have hard-coded it or you have made it into in a form of an input variable. So these are the different modeling techniques which we have to keep in mind once we create the model. Other checks are nothing but the self checks which we make when we construct a model which is given a 5 marks. So basically there needs to be six to seven minimum, I'm saying, self check in your spreadsheet, and this is your 12 marks. So in total, 42 marks is for entire my spreadsheet work. Okay. Then we have to make an audit trail in the Word file. Produce an audit trail for your spreadsheet model that includes the following aspects. So these subheadings should be there in your audit trail. The purpose of the model, which is nothing but the, you can say, the objective of creating this model. The data, the source of data, the data validation, you're performing any corrections which you're making on your data. Assumptions, again, assumptions is of 7 to 8 marks or maybe 10 marks for your assumptions is there. Then the methodology, which is nothing but how you have performed the calculation in the model in each stage. So this method will consider about so purpose of the model, data and assumptions, these two can be done in your 2 sheets, hardly take 2.5 sheets. Rest entire 4 to 5 pages will be your method. Okay. Explanation of any further checks. So these explanation, any reasonableness check, any self check which you have made will be included in your method as you are describing each and every point. You should ensure that your audit trail is suitable for both a senior, actually, as I mentioned, who has to approve your work. He has to just check whether your work is correct or not. He will basically check your audit trail only. And then you have your fellow student who will be just for there for peer review to correct your model, to add on things to your model. Okay. So let me read this entirely. Who has been asked to peer review and correct your model, to continue work on it or to use it again for a similar purpose in future. So basically, audit trail is when you create for your actuary, senior actuary, who will come back, who will only see your audit trail. He will not go through the model, he will not go through the spreadsheet. He will just see the audit trail, what you have written in your audit trail, the approach is correct or not. And the fellow student, the fellow colleague, he or she will only he or she will check your audit trail along with your spreadsheet and understand how and what you have done, what are the output which you have got, how the model can be improved, and if he wants to use that model in future. Even when you want to use model in the future, you will require an audit trail, because it might happen that you are coming back after 1 year to the same model. You might not get everything from the spreadsheet. You also need something in documentation form to understand what you have done in your spreadsheet. Okay. So marks available for audit trail. See, the communication skill. So basically, the communication should not be direct. You should not be saying that I have done this, I have done this. This is what we avoid. We generally say this has been done. This has been done in this particular cell. This is the output. You will never say I have got this output, I have done this. Do not talk in active terms. Okay, always in the passive form. Fellows, so this is 4 marks. Fellow student can review. Also, people ask that in audit trail spelling matters or not, grammatical mistakes matters or not. Obviously it matters. Okay, the English language should be clear. You should not use hi-fi languages, just a simple basic English language. Do not make any spelling mistakes. So obviously when you are doing it in Word file, your auto spelling checks are obviously on. Grammatical mistakes, you'll get green line if there are grammatical mistakes, blue lines in fact, and red lines for any spelling mistakes. So that should obviously be on so that you can understand what mistakes you have done. Fellow student can review your works. Senior actually can scrutinize and understand. So 7 marks to that. And logical order, meaning first you have to give the description about the data, purpose, assumption, and then the method. This should be the proper order. The content, the steps should be explained well. There should be signposting. Signposting meaning, suppose you have the base scenario. Then you have the stress scenario where you have changed the interest rates and all. So it should be properly in proper order, and there should be signposting. Signposting meaning you need to mention that, okay, this is the base scenario. In this sheet, we have considered all the base parameters. Then you explain everything. Come to the stress testing portion, and then you write in this sheet, we have made changes to these parameters, and then explain it. So there should be a clear signposting as to what is next, okay? Statement of assumptions, 5 marks. So as I said, 5 marks, you need to mention at least 7 to 8 assumptions. All models, if you're making 10 assumptions, that is the best thing you can do. All models, model steps accurately covered. Now these assumptions, again, coming back, some assumptions will give you entire 1 mark. Some assumptions will not give you entire 1 mark. They might give you only half a mark. So that is why you have to mention more than 5 assumptions. Also, the marks is only 5, but you will have to mention. What I will suggest is 10 assumptions you should always make. All steps should be clearly and accurately explained. So this entire gives you 58 marks. So the audit approach, audit content, will give you the entire 58 marks. So 58 here, and the rest is your 42 marks of your spreadsheet, correct? So now let us start with the background document. Is it fine, anyone? If you all have any doubts or queries still here, can we proceed?
Yeah.
Okay. Also, see, most of us will have different ways of studying these, just the background document which is given to us. What I do is, I don't use paper pen most of the time. I generally mark my things, because this is the Adobe Reader. I hope all of you are using Adobe Reader. If not, please download it, because it is the best to read a PDF file. So just you can mark through the important points because then you do not have to read the background document again and again. Because when you're making the model, trust me, you will need the background material again and again. So it is not feasible to read it again. You just have to come back to the points. Also, if you want, you can keep a pen paper. Some points which you want to keep in mind when you're constructing the model, you can write it down. So we will spend around a good amount of time today reading the model. If we get a more time, we will start constructing our spreadsheet. If not, tomorrow we will build upon that. Okay. So it says a major sporting event is taking place next year. The government has agreed to provide funding for sports scholarship to cover training and equipment for talented individuals. So the government is providing us scholarship. Okay. This is the thing. If you want to highlight, you may, you can avoid. If you think that, okay, I'll remember this thing, this is very simple, I can avoid this. But why have I highlighted this? Because this will be required in my statement of purpose. In the audit trail, when you are writing the statement of purpose, in that you have to mention, you have to give the purpose of making the model to the actuary, that we are making the model. This is the reason. Okay, these are the objectives of my model. The director of the National Shooting Organization, this is the name of the company or the organization, has asked your manager, a qualified actuary, to investigate the likely funding needed from the government for scholarships awarded to the national sporting team, national shooting team. Correct? Now, this organization has approached our manager. They want us to calculate the scholarship which we have to provide, which they will have to take from the government. Basically, they want to predict the amount of scholarship they will ask from the government. Scholarship trials are taking place in 3 months' time, after which the teams for the event will be selected. So the teams to which the scholarship will be given, they will be selected in 3 months' time. So scholarship trials will be starting in 3 months' time. Team selection will be on the basis of individuals' scores in trials. So selection of the team will be on the basis of the individual score of each candidate. Clear? Also, if I speak in Hindi, is there any issue? I'll be speaking in Hindi. That will be better, I think. Okay. Your manager has been asked to determine the expected number of eligible individuals. So this is the first thing which my manager wants me to do. He wants me to calculate the expected number of eligible individuals for scholarship, and hence the likely budget needed to fund them. So if I know my teams that these will be the eligible number of individuals who will get selected for my national shooting team, so I will know the budget as well. Correct? The national shooting team will consist of a senior team. So there are two teams, senior team and a junior team. The junior team is for competitors who are aged 21 and younger. So these are the points which I think are important for me. You all can also highlight those. Again, when we are highlighting, do not try and highlight everything. Okay. When you do 2-3 papers, you will realize, okay, these are the things which are important, these are not. But again, do not try and highlight each and everything which you see. This is not the thing, because otherwise you'll see that you have ended up marking the entire question paper. There is a minimum qualifying score, MQS, the short form, which determines the eligibility for inclusion of an individual in each team. So each individual needs to score a minimum score, needs to be scored by each individual in order to qualify the teams. And there are two teams, senior team and a junior team. Junior team is for the candidates, competitors who are aged 21 exactly or less. Shooting competitions are scored using 10 rounds of 10 shots, known as a card. So this shooting competition are scored using 10 rounds of 10 shots in one card known as a card. Now this card is nothing but this one round. In one card, a competitor can score a maximum of 100 points. So how do you analyze this? Can anyone tell me? How do you analyze, how do you understand basically the this two lines over here? Adarsh or anyone? Siddhi, Gatika? How do you understand this two points, two lines which have been written?
I guess the maximum, those who scored out of 100 will be the maximum. Like, suppose someone is like at 90 or someone is 80, so 91 is the like the winner, basically.
Okay. Anyone else? I think Siddhi, your voice is not audible.
Hello?
Yes.
Yeah. No, I have already said that. I think like out of like maximum.
Okay. So Adarsh, do you want to add on? Kritika, Adarsh?
No, I think we can use a max function here. I mean 10 into 10, so 100. So
do not ever, jabhi bhi hum log model, jabhi hum log background read kare, do not ever think about ki ye function hum yahan pe use kar sakte, because aapko pata nahi hai ki what is the question asking for. This is just the background which has been given to us. Correct. Hume pehle samajhna hai ki what it is saying, because this seemed a little vague to me. The way they have written the shooting competitions are scored using 10 rounds of 10 shots. Now these 10 shots each, ki ek round mein there are 10 shots, ya fir 10 rounds of 10 shots in total.
Yeah, so that was my confusion, whether each competitor has one card or 10 cards.
Correct. So this, that is why I asked you this question, because this seemed a little vague to me, and you will get these vague lines in your model, no doubt.
I mean, I worked with an assumption in my mind that if it is 100 point and 100 shots, so one shot will be 1 point. I mean,
yeah, correct. That can be the thing. Basically, you are considering ki 10 rounds hai. Har ek round mein there is 10 shot. This is what you are considering. Okay, yeah, so there are 100 shots
and 100 points. So one shot, 1 point. That was my assumption.
Correct. Okay, we can keep any of the assumption abhi ke liye, before we proceed reading the question. Because maybe hum log ko aage padhne se aur clear ho sakta hai. So now, for now, it is saying ki 10 rounds hai and of 10 shots, known as a card. And this card I am considering is for the round. Each round is a card. This is what I am considering. Or in your case, you can consider ki 10 rounds ka ek card hai. And ek card ke total 100 points ho sakte, maximum. Clear? Any of the assumption we can keep in mind abhi ke liye. Moving on, the team director. So again, this is an important thing which we have to cover in the audit trail. कोई भी कहीं से भी हमें डेटा मिले, दैट इज इम्पोर्टेंट सोर्स विच वी हैव टू मेंशन इन द ऑडिट ट्रेल. सो द टीम डायरेक्टर हैज प्रोवाइडेड डिटेल्स ऑफ द लास्ट 20 कार्ड्स शॉट बाय 100 इंडिविजुअल्स. सो आई हैव 20 कार्ड्स ऑफ 100 इंडिविजुअल्स. सो आई हैव 100 इंडिविजुअल्स इन टोटल, 100 कैंडिडेट्स बेसिकली, who have been actively participating in the sport. He has only provided details of competitors who always shoot a score of 90 or above out of 100 per card. So now we can clarify on this assumption that one card is of 100 points, that is there. Now the team director has given us the information about last 20 cards. Now we are not bothered ki har ek card mein kitne rounds hai, kitne shots hai, kyunki unka kuch bhi idhar mention nahi kiya hua. To kuch assumption lene ka zarurat pad hi nahi sakta, maybe, kyunki wo hame directly use karna hi nahi pade model mein. हमें दिया हुआ है इंफॉर्मेशन ऑन द लास्ट 20 कार्ड्स ऑफ 100 कैंडिडेट्स, एंड वो जो 20 कार्ड्स है ईच कार्ड ऑफ इज ऑफ 100 मार्क्स, एंड कितने कैंडिडेट्स का डेटा है, खाली उन्हीं कैंडिडेट्स का डेटा है हु स्कोर्ड अबव 90 और अबव. सो एनीवन स्कोरिंग 80 इन अ पर्टिकुलर कार्ड, उसका इंफॉर्मेशन हमारे पास नहीं है. ओनली दोज कैंडिडेट्स जिन्होंने हर एक कार्ड में 90 या फिर 90 के अबव स्कोर किया है, खाली उनका इंफॉर्मेशन वी हैव. सी इट इज रिटन पर कार्ड, सो इन ऑल द 20 कार्ड्स द कैंडिडेट शुड हैव स्कोर्ड 90 और अबव. इज दिस क्लियर? एंड व्हाई आई एम स्ट्रेसिंग ऑन दिस, एवरी पॉइंट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट व्हेन वी मेक द ऑडिट ट्रेल एंड वी मेक द स्प्रेडशीट एंड डेटा करेक्शंस एंड ऑल ऑफ इट. क्लियर?
आई हैव अ कंफ्यूजन हियर. जैसे यहाँ पे लिखा है इन्होंने 20 कार्ड्स, लास्ट 20 कार्ड्स शॉर्ट बाय 100 इंडिविजुअल्स हु हैव बीन एक्टिवली पार्टिसिपेटिंग, बट यहाँ से समझ में आ गया दैट वन राउंड इज वन कार्ड. आई मीन इट इज क्लियर, इट कैन नॉट बी दैट द एंटायर इज द वन कार्ड, इट इज वन राउंड एंड ईच इंडिविजुअल हैज 10 कार्ड्स.
ओके,
व्हिच बीइंग वन राउंड, ये लास्ट 20 कार्ड शॉर्ट बाय 100 इंडिविजुअल कैसे हो सकता है? मतलब वही कंफ्यूजन है, बिकॉज ईच इंडिविजुअल इज गेटिंग 10 cards. If we assume that one round is one card, we cannot assume that one shot is one card.
So basically, यहाँ पे हो रहा है कि shooting competitions are scored using 10 rounds. तो एक competition में there are 10 rounds and each round is of 10 shot. This is of one competition. Correct. यहाँ पे एक बार भी mention नहीं किया कि we have just taken one competition का every detail.
अच्छा.
करेक्ट. यहाँ पे खाली दिया हुआ लास्ट 20 कार्ड, यानी कि लास्ट 20 कॉम्पिटिशन्स का हमने डिटेल्स दिया. सो व्हेन यू मेक अ क्रिकेट टीम, यू बेस योर डिसीजन नॉट ओनली ऑन द एकदम रिसेंटली वाला परफॉर्मेंस, बट मे बी ऑल द 20 30 मैचेस प्लेड बाय द.
बट हां, बट व्हेन वी यूज दिस डेफिनेशन ऑफ कॉम्पिटिशन्स, वी स्टिल आर नॉट क्लियर वेदर दे आर कंसीडरिंग राउंड्स एज वन कार्ड और द एंटायर कॉम्पिटिशन एज वन.
करेक्ट,
बट वी डू नॉट केयर.
करेक्ट. सो एज आई सेड, ये दोनों लाइन अभी भी वेग है, बट ऐसा देखो, हो सकता है कि हमारे मॉडल में बहुत इंफॉर्मेशन हो, जरूरी नहीं कि सारे इंफॉर्मेशन हमें यूज करना है. समझ रहे हो? इन ऑर्डर टू मेक, हमारे बैकग्राउंड में देयर कैन बी लॉट ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन. इट इज नॉट ऑलवेज मैंडेटरी कि हम लोग सारा इंफॉर्मेशन, या फिर जरूरत ही नहीं पड़े कि हम लोग सारे इंफॉर्मेशन यूज करें अपने मॉडल में. When we construct the model, that totally depends on the question. अगर question, तो अभी अगर हम लोग यहाँ रुक जाएंगे और इस पे ज़्यादा दिमाग लगाने लग गए, and when we read the question, हम लोग देख रहे हैं कि ये है ही नहीं उधर. Correct. तो कोई फायदा नहीं. अभी के लिए you can assume two things, whatever is coming to your mind, कि 10 rounds है और 10 rounds का एक card है, या फिर एक round का एक card है. बट ये क्लियर हो सकता है कि एक राउंड में 10 शॉट्स है, क्योंकि ऑब्वियसली 10 राउंड में एक, मतलब एक राउंड में एक शॉट नहीं होगा, देन इट मेक्स नो सेंस. तो 10 राउंड्स है, हर एक राउंड में देयर आर 10 शॉट्स, एंड दो अजम्पशन अभी मुझे दिख रहा है, एक कि एक राउंड इज वन कार्ड, या फिर 10 राउंड्स इज इक्विवेलेंट टू वन कार्ड. बट यहाँ पे अलग से व्हेन दे हैव रिटन, यहाँ पे वी आर क्लियर कि 20 कार्ड्स है, ठीक है, जो हमें जिनके बारे में इन्फॉर्मेशन दिया है. एंड यहाँ पे एक और चीज क्लियर है कि ईच कार्ड का मैक्सिमम 100 हो सकता है. ईच कार्ड, तो अगर 20 कार्ड्स है हमारे पास, ईच कार्ड में 100 पॉसिबल है, तो टोटल कितना पॉसिबल हुआ?
टोटल अगर इफ वी आर थिंकिंग ऑफ द एंटायर कॉम्पिट, इधर तो 2000
कार्ड
में एक कैंडिडेट के लिए, इफ यू आर द फर्स्ट अजम्पशन व्हेन द एंटायर कंपटीशन इज वन कार्ड, देन इट इज 100. इफ वन कार्ड इज 100 पॉइंट्स, लाइक 10 शॉट्स इज वन कार्ड, देन 1000 पॉइंट्स विल बी द पॉसिबिलिटी टोटल में एक कंपटीशन.
तुम अजम्पशन नहीं अपने मन से बना सकते हो व्हेन इट इज गिवन इन द क्वेश्चन. सो इट इज गिवन इन द क्वेश्चन कि वन कार्ड कैन, द मैक्सिमम ऑफ वन कार्ड इज 100 पॉइंट्स.
करेक्ट.
तो यहाँ पे कंपटीशन या फिर राउंड के बारे में कुछ नहीं बोला, डायरेक्टली बोला है कि वन कार्ड में देयर इज मैक्सिमम 100 पॉइंट्स. अगर 20 कार्ड्स का इंफॉर्मेशन मुझे हर एक कैंडिडेट का दिया है, मैक्सिमम द कैंडिडेट कैन स्कोर इज 20 इनटू 100.
हाँ, वो तो है.
ठीक है, हाँ तो ये हो गया, करेक्ट 2000. एंड एक और चीज हमें ध्यान रखना है कि ओनली दोज कैंडिडेट्स जिन्होंने 90 या फिर उसके अबव स्कोर किए, खाली उनका मेरे पास इन्फॉर्मेशन है, करेक्ट? ओके, सो द डेटा, ठीक है, सो द डेटा प्रोवाइडर शोज कॉम्पिटिटर स्कोर्स फॉर 20 कार्ड्स शॉट ओवर अ डिस्टेंस ऑफ 25 मीटर्स. तो हर एक कैंडिडेट का, हर एक कॉम्पिटिटर का मुझे 20 कार्ड्स का इन्फॉर्मेशन, लास्ट 20 कार्ड्स का इन्फॉर्मेशन दिया है. हर एक कार्ड में मैक्सिमम ही कैन स्कोर 100, एंड कितने डिस्टेंस तक, शूटिंग कॉम्पिटिशन है ना, तो डिस्टेंस आएगा इधर 25 मीटर्स का डिस्टेंस का दिया हुआ है खाली, ठीक है. द ट्रायल्स विल कंसिस्ट ऑफ 20 कार्ड्स इन टोटल. तो ट्रायल के बेसिस पे हम लोग डिसाइड करेंगे. ट्रायल अभी हुआ नहीं है, 3 मंथ्स के बाद होगा. अभी तक हमारे पास लिस्ट है सारे कैंडिडेट्स का, पास्ट परफॉर्मेंस का, बट ट्रायल के बेसिस पे सिलेक्शन होगा. हमें नहीं पता कि कैसा क्या सिलेक्शन होगा, ट्रायल कैसा होगा, बट हमें पास्ट एक्सपीरियंस के हिसाब से फ्यूचर प्रिडिक्ट करना है. क्लियर हो रहा है कुछ कुछ? सो द ट्रायल्स विल कंसिस्ट ऑफ 20 कार्ड्स इन टोटल. The first 10 cards being shot over a distance of 50 meters and the next 10 being shot over a distance of 100 meters. तो क्या बोला है, देखो 20 cards का trial होगा in 3 months. ऊपर दिया हुआ था यहाँ पे that the scholarship trials, जिनको scholarship मिलना चाहिए वो, उसके लिए competition कब होगा, 3 months के बाद. तो वो trial किसका कंसिस्ट करेगा, 20 कार्ड्स का कंसिस्ट करेगा. पहला 10 कार्ड होगा 50 मीटर्स डिस्टेंस का एंड दूसरा 10 कार्ड होगा 100 मीटर्स डिस्टेंस का. बट मेरे पास डेटा किसका है, 25 मीटर्स का डेटा है. ये पूरा क्लियर है, ठीक है. फॉर ईच कॉम्पिटिटर द ट्रायल स्कोर, दैट इज द स्कोर यूज्ड टू डिटरमाइन द टीम सिलेक्शन. टोटल फॉर ईच कॉम्पिटिटर द ट्रायल स्कोर, जो भी ट्रायल होगा उस समय जो स्कोर होगा उस पर डिपेंड करेगा कि वो सिलेक्ट होगा कि नहीं. विल बी द टोटल स्कोर अचीव्ड ओवर द 20 कार्ड्स. तो पूरे 20 कार्ड्स में उस पूरे ट्रायल के दौरान जितना भी माई टोटल स्कोर विल बी अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट टोटल स्कोर माई असेसमेंट विल बी मेड. इट इज नॉट इंडिविजुअल कार्ड के ऊपर बट टोटल. और टोटल हमने अभी देखा 20 × 100, 2000 इज पॉसिबल. Correct. This gives a maximum possible trial score for each competitor as 2000. So, इन्होंने भी clarify कर दिया कि 2000 is the final score which is possible. Clear? Clear? Competitors achieving the relevant MQS. MQS अगर आपको याद है ऊपर, minimum कहाँ गया? Escape कहीं पे था ना? इधर, ठीक है. सो द मिनिमम क्वालिफाइंग स्कोर, ओके. सो द मिनिमम क्वालिफाइंग स्कोर विल बी ऑफर्ड अ प्लेस इन द नेशनल टीम. तो हमने एक मिनिमम स्कोर सेट किया है, जिनका भी इसके ऊपर आता है दे विल बी सिलेक्टेड इन द नेशनल टीम. द स्कॉलरशिप अमाउंट्स विल बी अवॉर्डेड पर टीम मेंबर. तो एक टीम मेंबर को इतना मिलेगा अमाउंट एंड द एमक्यूएस रिक्वायर्ड फॉर द टीम इज एज फॉलोस. तो ये हमें डेटा दिया हुआ है. एमक्यूएस स्कोर आउट ऑफ 2000 क्यों, 20 कार्ड्स है, 20 × 100. सो सीनियर टीम का दिस इज द मिनिमम क्वालिफाइंग स्कोर. इतना हर एक कैंडिडेट, इतना 1950, इतना या फिर इसके ज्यादा स्कोर करेगा तो उसे हम अपनी टीम में लेंगे. एंड पर टीम मेंबर हम कितना देंगे, 20,000. तो हर एक कैंडिडेट जो सिलेक्ट हो रहा है उसको हम 20,000 देंगे. सिमिलरली द सेम इज गिवन फॉर द जूनियर टीम. कॉम्पिटिटर्स अचीविंग अ स्कोर इक्वल और हायर, तो या तो 1950 या फिर इससे ज्यादा, जिन्होंने पूरा आउट ऑफ 2000 स्कोर किया उनको हम सिलेक्ट करेंगे, विल बी ऑफर्ड अ प्लेस इन द टीम एंड विल बी रिसीविंग द scholarship amount. There is no restriction on the numbers. So it can be any number. Senior team में कितने भी लोग हो सकते हैं, junior team में कितने भी लोग हो सकते हैं. All members achieving the MQS will be offered a place in the team and will receive a scholarship. So it will not depend कि कितना हमने एक minimum number रखा है. That does not matter यहाँ पे. क्लियर है? ठीक है, नाउ द बेस सिनेरियो. योर मैनेजर हैज आस्क्ड यू टू एनालाइज द डेटा प्रोवाइडेड. So analyze the data provided is obviously always present. Data जो दिया है उसको देखो कि सही है कि नहीं. And then to produce a set of simulations of the trial scores. For trial scores का simulation produce. So basically हमें trial scores पता नहीं है कितना है. We have just the information about the last 20 cards. Correct? उसको use करके हमें निकालने की ट्रायल में उसका कितना आएगा कैंडिडेट का फॉर ईच 100 इंडिविजुअल आइडेंटिफाइड बाय द टीम डायरेक्टर. तो टीम डायरेक्टर ने जो मुझे डेटा दिया था उसको यूज करके हमें ट्रायल स्कोर को सिम्युलेट यानी कि प्रिडिक्ट करना है. द सिम्युलेशन रिक्वायर्स एडजस्टेड स्कोर्स दैट आर कैलकुलेटेड ऑन द पॉइंट्स ड्रॉप्ड बेसिस. दैट इज points dropped is equal to 100 minus the scores obtained. तो ये अगर मुझे कोई clarify कर पाए कि points ये क्या बोला है इधर, points dropped का मतलब. एक बार try करो बोलने का.
It's a shooting competition है, अगर डार्ट तक नहीं पहुंचा अगर नीचे जमीन में गिर गया तो it will be like whatever the score that you have received minus 100.
Correct. तो जो भी हमारा last 20 cards दिया हुआ है information, we should always remember कि वो 90 या 90 के above का ही दिया हुआ है. Points dropped हम कैसे निकालेंगे? 100 minus जो भी हमें points हमने score किया. Correct? 100 minus 90, 100 minus 95 and so on. तो इसको लेके हम आगे का कैलकुलेशन परफॉर्म करेंगे. टू सिम्युलेट द स्कोर्स ऑफ फॉर द 50 मीटर एंड 100 मीटर इवेंट्स फ्रॉम द 25 मीटर डेटा. तो 25 मीटर का डेटा हमें दिया हुआ है पर हमें निकालना है ट्रायल स्कोर्स, प्रिडिक्ट करना है फॉर 50 मीटर्स 10 कार्ड्स, फॉर 100 मीटर्स 10 कार्ड्स. द फॉलोइंग फॉर्मूला इज यूज्ड. तो अब देखो यहाँ पे पूरा फॉर्मूला दिया हुआ है. Distance 50 meters, 100 meters, score out of 100 for card I, for competitor N. तो I जा रहा है 1 से. I think यहाँ पे एक गलती है in the question. This should be not I actually, क्योंकि card खाली 20 है. तो this should be N actually. ठीक है, there is a correction over here. यहाँ पे N होना चाहिए 1 from 100. Competitors 100 है, कार्ड्स खाली हमारे पास 20 है. सो देयर इज अ करेक्शन इन द क्वेश्चन.
आई गेस इट्स इन अ लूप. मतलब फॉर एग्जांपल आई डू कोडिंग, सो व्हेनेवर इंसटेड ऑफ एन वी राइट आई. सो उसमें क्या होता है ना कि आपको बार बार फॉर्मूला नहीं लिखना पड़ता है.
नहीं वो तो एक्चुअली नहीं, एक्चुअली वो नहीं है इधर केस. बिकॉज इफ यू सी कोडिंग में भी हम लोग जब दो वेरिएबल लेते हैं एक लूप के अंदर एक और लूप बनाते हैं हम लोग. तो वी टेक टू वेरिएबल्स, वी कैन टेक मोर देन वन वेरिएबल इन अ लूप. हम लोग जो दो लूप एक के अंदर एक और लूप बनाते हैं. सो दैट इज नॉट द थिंग विच इज हैपनिंग यहाँ पे. बट यहाँ पे देर इज अ मिस्टेक क्योंकि आई विच इज फॉर कार्ड दैट कैनॉट गो अप टू 100. तो ये एन होना चाहिए 1 to 100.
50 मीटर्स के साइड में लिखा हुआ भी है 50 और 100. आई बिटवीन 1 एंड 10 एंड आई बिटवीन 11 एंड 20.
करेक्ट करेक्ट, इसीलिए मैंने बोला मिस्टेक. हाँ हो सकते हैं, देर आर मिस्टेक्स इन द पेपर, स्मॉल स्मॉल मिस्टेक्स विच यू सी, नॉट एन इश्यू. सो ओके डू नॉट, हम लोग को इस पर इतना स्ट्रेस नहीं देना इधर. बट ओके सो कॉम्पिटिटर एन एंड कार्ड आई. सो इफ दे आर सेइंग दैट कॉम्पिटिटर एन, तो एन तो इन्होंने कहीं मेंशन ही नहीं किया. करेक्ट, दे शुड हैव मेंशन समथिंग ओवर हियर. एनीवेज सो मिनिमम ऑफ 100 कॉमा 100 माइनस आरवी जो भी अभी हम लोग को एक्सप्लेन किया हुआ रहेगा प्लस पॉइंट्स ड्रॉप्ड का स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन है आई थिंक ये जो हमने आगे एक्सप्लेन किया हुआ है डिवाइड बाय 4. सो दिस इज बेसिकली द फॉर्मूला विच इज गिवन टू कैलकुलेट. नाउ इफ यू ऑल कैन जस्ट एक्सप्लेन मी कि इससे हमें क्या मिलेगा. इफ एनी वन ऑफ यू कैन जस्ट एक्सप्लेन पहला 10 के लिए एंड दूसरा 10 के लिए फॉर 50 मीटर्स 100 मीटर्स इससे हमें क्या मिलेगा जस्ट. Anyone? Siddhi, Adarsh, Gitika?
आई थिंक इससे हमें रेंज मिलेगा एक, मतलब इफ एक बार के लिए मेन हटा दे तो जो रेंज है 100 से लेके जो वो ये आया, सो इफ इफ इट गोज बियॉन्ड 100 सो वी कैन नॉट स्कोर मोर देन 100, एज सिंपल एज दैट. बट इफ इट फॉल्स डाउन सो वी आर गिविंग अ रेंज इन बिटवीन विच द पार्टिसिपेंट्स विल स्कोर, हु विल क्वालिफाई ऑन द बेसिस की जो बेस्ट पार्टिसिपेंट्स थे 25 मीटर्स के ऊपर में.
ओके सिद्धि, यू वांट टू ट्राई? आई
एम जस्ट थिंकिंग, आई थिंक मतलब गिव मी अ मिनट, आई हैव टू थिंक.
हाँ आराम से सोच के बताओ. सी द आंसर टू माय क्वेश्चन इज हियर ओनली, एक बार रीड करो आप लोग अच्छे से. एनीवन? आदर्श तुमने ना थोड़ा गलत बोला है, सो इफ यू कैन ट्राई अगेन. सो बेसिकली वी हैव 25 मीटर का डेटा गिवन टू अस. ट्रायल्स में 50 मीटर एंड 100 मीटर्स का के ऊपर कंपटीशन होगा. 10 कार्ड्स होंगे 50 मीटर के, अदर 10 विल बी ऑफ 100 मीटर्स, करेक्ट? तो हमें डेटा दिया हुआ है ऑफ 20 कार्ड्स ऑफ 25 मीटर. नाउ वी हैव टू प्रिडिक्ट द ट्रायल स्कोर्स ऑफ 50 मीटर 100 मीटर यूजिंग द 25 मीटर का इंफॉर्मेशन व्हिच इज गिवन टू अस. तो यहाँ पे हम लोग वही स्कोर प्रिडिक्ट कर रहे हैं. सो पहला 10 कार्ड हम ले रहे हैं ऑफ 25 मीटर जो दिया हुआ है, उससे हम 50 मीटर का स्कोर प्रिडिक्ट करेंगे हर एक कार्ड का अलग अलग. एंड यहाँ पे नेक्स्ट 10 कार्ड जो 25 मीटर्स का है उसको यूज करके हम 100 मीटर्स का स्कोर प्रिडिक्ट करेंगे. अभी क्लियर है? थोड़ा लाइक वी रीड द क्वेश्चन अगेन तो समझ में आएगा. इज इट बेटर सिद्धि एंड आदर्श?
यस सर.
ओके सो नाउ आई मीन सबको एक्सप्लेन किया हुआ है. पॉइंट्स ड्रॉप्ड ST.N इज द स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन ऑफ द पॉइंट्स ड्रॉप्ड ओवर द 20 रिजल्ट्स फ्रॉम द 25 मीटर डेटा फॉर कॉम्पिटिटर एन. तो हर एक कॉम्पिटिटर 100 कॉम्पिटिटर्स है, सबका 20 20 कार्ड्स है सबका. एंड उनका हम हर एक इंडिविजुअल का, हर एक कॉम्पिटिटर का 20 कार्ड्स का हम स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन निकाल रहे हैं ऑफ पॉइंट्स ड्रॉप्ड. ये वो दिया हुआ है हमें. आर वी इज अ रैंडम वेरिएबल कॉम्पोनेंट इन द फॉर्मूला, इज एन एक्सपोनेंशियल रैंडम वेरिएबल. सो दिस इज टेकन फ्रॉम द एक्सपोनेंशियल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन फैमिली दैट वेरीज बाय कार्ड आई एंड कॉम्पिटिटर एन, करेक्ट? नाउ इसके बारे में इंफॉर्मेशन आगे दिया हुआ है. द रैंडम वेरिएबल कैन बी कैलकुलेटेड यूजिंग द मीन एंड द स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन ऑफ द पॉइंट्स ड्रॉप्ड फॉर ईच कॉम्पिटिटर एन. हर एक कॉम्पिटिटर का हमेशा याद रखना 20 कार्ड्स दिया हुआ है ऑफ 25 मीटर ईच. एंड ऐसा कुछ हमारा रैंडम वेरिएबल का एक्सप्रेशन बनेगा, माइनस लॉग ऑफ यू आई एन. व्हाट इज यू आई एन? नीचे दिया हुआ है, डिवाइडेड बाय लैम्डा एन. सो लैम्डा एन फॉर कॉम्पिटिटर एन, सो देयर 100 कॉम्पिटिटर्स, इज सिम्युलेटेड फ्रॉम एन एक्सपोनेंशियल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन विथ डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन दिस. सो 50 मीटर्स के लिए जो हम लैम्डा एन यूज करेंगे दैट विल बी 1 डिवाइडेड बाय पॉइंट्स ड्रॉप्ड मीन, पॉइंट्स ड्रॉप्ड स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन. एंड 100 मीटर्स के लिए जो हम यूज करेंगे दैट विल बी 1 डिवाइडेड बाय पॉइंट्स ड्रॉप्ड मीन, 2 into पॉइंट्स ड्रॉप स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन. अभी के लिए अगर ये बहुत ओवरवेलमिंग लग रहा है, नॉट एन इश्यू एट ऑल, बट जो हम लोग सॉल्व करेंगे धीरे धीरे समझ में आएगा स्टेप बाय स्टेप. ऊपर में क्वेश्चंस दिए हुए हैं लाइन से जो हमने स्किप किया था फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, वो जब हम लोग एक एक करके सॉल्व करेंगे ना तो हमें सब कुछ समझ में आने लगेगा. बट दिस इज द बेसिक कैलकुलेशन ऑफ द रैंडम वेरिएबल लॉग एन डिवाइडेड बाय लैम्डा. एंड लैम्डा का कैलकुलेशन दिया हुआ है. लैम्डा इज नथिंग बट अ पैरामीटर ऑफ द एक्सपोनेंशियल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन, उसको हम ऐसे करके निकाल रहे हैं. फाइन. Now, UIN is the random variable from the uniform 0,1 distribution. So, ab ye hai, ye uniform 0,1 distribution ko follow karega. Correct? Randomly jo hume diya rahega. To simulate the 20 cards for each of the 100 competitors, 10 for the 50 meters, 10 for the 100 meters, your manager now has provided you with 2000 random variables. 2000 random variables यानी कि उसने ये provide करा है हमें, ठीक है? अभी हम देखेंगे spreadsheet में उसने हमें क्या provide करा है. That were generated from the continuous uniform distribution 0,1. After completing, तो ये किसने दिया मुझे? ये मेरे manager ने दिया. You always have to keep in mind कि जो data हमारे पास है, वो किसने दिया? What is the source of the data? Which is very important जब हम लोग auditory लिखते हैं. After completing the simulations of the trial scores, your manager has asked you to use these simulations to determine the number of places. तो हमने अभी trial score ये सब use करके formula use करके निकाला. इसके बाद the main task is obviously to see कि कितने number of places are to be offered in each team. मतलब कि senior team and junior team में हमने कितने कितने candidates को select किया है. And hence the overall sponsorship which is required. तो जितने भी candidate हैं multiplied with the स्पॉन्सरशिप जो हमें मिल रहा है, क्योंकि हर एक कैंडिडेट को सेपरेटली मिल रहा है, एंड देन वी एड इट फॉर जूनियर एंड द सीनियर एंड वी गेट द टोटल बजट जो हमें, दिस इज व्हाट वी हैव प्रिडिक्टेड कि इतना हमें गवर्नमेंट से चाहिएगा. सो ऑब्वियसली बजट्स तो ऐसे ही क्रिएट होते हैं, एवरीथिंग इज बेस्ड ऑन फोरकास्टिंग एंड प्रिडिक्शन. इक्वालिटी सिनेरियो, नाउ दैट वाज द बेस सिनेरियो, पहला सिनेरियो. नाउ दिस इज द सेकंड सिनेरियो व्हिच इज गिवन टू अस. The team director has heard that the board of national shooting organization wants to promote the sport to younger people and so wants to ensure equal number of seniors and juniors to receive the scholarship. तो हो सकता है कि seniors को ज्यादा मिल रहा हो, juniors को कम मिल रहा हो, क्योंकि seniors ज्यादा qualify कर रहे हो, seniors juniors कम qualify कर रहे हो. In order to bridge that gap, they want equal number of seniors and juniors in the team. तो junior team में अगर 10 लोग हैं, अगर senior team में 10 लोग हैं, तो junior team में भी 10 लोग होंगे. This is what they want. ठीक है? Your manager would like you to model this by changing the MQS of juniors. तो हमें क्या चेंज करना है? The minimum qualifying score जो दिया हुआ है हमें junior senior का अलग अलग, हमें junior का change करना है so that the number of juniors being awarded the scholarship is equal to the number of seniors. ठीक है? Your manager is out of the office and cannot be contacted for the next 3 hours. They would like the above cancellations to be finished and documented in a audit trail ready for their return. So ये पूरा चीज का हमें स्प्रेडशीट में मॉडल बनाना है एंड देन वी हैव टू डॉक्यूमेंट इट इन द ऑडिट ट्रेल. सो इफ यू ऑल कैन सी, क्लास में हमें अराउंड 40 मिनट्स लगा है टू रीड द क्वेश्चन, 40-45 मिनट्स. दिस इज बिकॉज हमने काफी डिस्कशंस किया, धीरे धीरे किया. दिस विल कम डाउन स्लोली टू 20 मिनट्स. ठीक है? तो वो दैट इज अ डिफरेंट थिंग. बट एक बार के लिए बस डेटा जो हमें दिया हुआ है क्वेश्चन में, यू विल सी ऐसा नेम किया हुआ होगा शीट में, डेटा फॉर द कैंडिडेट्स. तो हम डेटा एक बार समझते हैं आज के लिए एंड देन टुमारो वी विल बिल्ड अपॉन इट. तो हमें दिया हुआ है रॉ डेटा, कॉम्पिटिटर स्कोर्स एट 25 मीटर्स. तो ये हमने किसने दिया था? टीम डायरेक्टर ने दिया था. लास्ट 20 कार्ड्स का, सो इफ यू सी स्कोर्स पर राउंड. Now Adarsh, what you can say ki har ek round is one card. Can you say this now? Because 20 cards ka information hai, they are saying scores per round. So now this is being clarified. So 20
round. मेरा question था इसके पहले जो ये equality scenario जो आया था, तो मतलब जैसे कि इन्होंने equality scenario को एक अलग से sub heading में दिया, तो जब हमारा answer sheet जो बनेगा solution sheet, उसमें पहले हम लोग को जब इन जब इक्वालिटी सिनेरियो इंपोज नहीं है वो रिजल्ट भी देना है. Correct. और इक्वालिटी सिनेरियो वो भी देना है कि
देना.
जब हम लोग रिपोर्ट करेंगे देन वी विल ओनली रिपोर्ट द इक्वालिटी वन, व्हिच वन वी विल डू.
दोनों ना. हां, बिकॉज़ दे हैव सेड ना पहले यहां पे कि निकालो एंड देन दे हैव आस्क्ड. सो यू विल बी गिवन, यहां पे खाली दो सिनेरियो है, हमें दो से ज्यादा भी मिल सकते हैं.
हाँ नहीं, वो जब ये लास्ट लाइन की वजह से कंफ्यूजन हो गया कि दे वुड लाइक दी अबव कैलकुलेशन फिनिश एंड डॉक्यूमेंटेड इन एन ऑडिट ट्रेल, ये पहले नहीं लिखा हुआ था तो
अच्छा
थोड़ा।
कि
हाँ
ये पूरे के लिए,
देखो,
पूरे के लिए दिस यू विल,
अच्छा
दिस लाइन यू विल सी इन ऑल द क्वेश्चन पेपर,
अच्छा ओ
दिस लाइन यू विल सी इन ऑल द क्वेश्चन पेपर्स. हमने एक चीज जो
हाँ
स्किप करा था, ये वाला, ये हमने स्किप करा था क्वेश्चंस. तो जब हम इनको फॉलो करेंगे ना, हमें सब समझ आ जाएगा कि हमें क्या क्या करना है स्टेप बाय स्टेप. सो दिस इज अ गुड थिंग जो IFOA करता है अपने पेपर्स में, उन लोग ऐसे क्वेश्चंस दे देता है ताकि हमें समझ में आ जाए स्टेप बाय स्टेप. आपने पहले के पेपर्स
हाँ
में अगर दिए हैं तो सीएम वाले सब में भी व्हाट दे डू इज दे गिव
हाँ
स्टेप वाइज ना,
ब्रेक इट
ब्रेक
डाउन।
इट डाउन. या दिस इज अ बेनिफिट ऑफ IFOA, बट नेवरदलेस IIA इज आल्सो इजी सी, मतलब इक्वली सेम इफ वी सी लाइक दैट. तो ये हो गया अभी क्लियर हमारा. एंड देयर इज एज बैंड इफ यू सी, जूनियर जे के लिए एंड एस के लिए सीनियर है, एंड दीज आर द मार्क्स व्हिच इज गिवन टू अस, स्कोर्स बेसिकली. ओके, इफ यू सी द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, खाली हम लोग अभी करेंगे नहीं, बट इट इज आस्किंग अस टू वैलिडेट ऑल द डेटा प्रोवाइडेड टू अस. ओके, नाउ व्हेन दिस से, दिस इज एवरी टाइम यू विल गेट दिस, वैलिडेट द डेटा व्हिच इज गिवन, यानी कि यू हैव टू वैलिडेट द स्कोर्स. नाउ व्हाट आर द वैलिडेशंस व्हिच यू कैन मेक?
इट कैन नॉट बी ग्रेटर देन 100 एंड लेस देन 0। वन सेकंड,
आर यू श्योर? जीरो?
एक सेकंड। अरे
सिद्धि?
नाइन्टी के ऊपर होना चाहिए आइडियली.
करेक्ट करेक्ट,
साइड अब मार्क्स अबव 90.
करेक्ट, उसमें लिखा हुआ था कि उन्हें खाली हमें वही इंफॉर्मेशन वही कैंडिडेट्स का दिया है जिनका स्कोर वाज 90 और अबव 90.
और एक
तो
चेक कर सकते हैं कि एज बैंड कैन नॉट बी एनीथिंग अदर देन जेएनएस, आई मीन फॉर
करेक्ट
डेटा में।
करेक्ट करेक्ट, दिस इज वेरी गुड आदर्श. तो जे एंड एस खाली ये हो सकते हैं. सो देर आर डिफरेंट चेक्स हम लोग इस पे परफॉर्म करेंगे, कैसे परफॉर्म करेंगे वो कल करेंगे. सो दैट इज गुड, स्टार्टिंग के लिए एकदम सही है. देन वी हैव द डेटा सिमुलेशन. सो दिस इज गिवन टू अस बाय आर मैनेजर, द रैंडम नंबर्स फ्रॉम यूनिफॉर्म 0,1. एंड इफ यू सी, ये है पहला 10, दिस इज फर्स्ट 10 एंड दिस इज द नेक्स्ट 10 सिमुलेशन यूनिफॉर्म, जो हमारा क्वेश्चन में ये दिया हुआ था ना, मैं एक बार आ जाती हूँ फॉर्मूला में. बेसिकली ये दिया हुआ है UI,N. करेक्ट, एंड ये अलग अलग क्यों दिया हुआ है? बिकॉज 50 मीटर्स के लिए अलग से करेंगे, 100 मीटर्स के लिए अलग से करेंगे, तो ये अलग
बट
अलग
UIN दिया हुआ या लैम्डा दिया हुआ है?
यू दिया हुआ है बिकॉज लैम्डा हमें निकालना है. देखो
लैम्डा हमें निकालना है ना, यू इज गिवन एंड लैम्डा हमें निकालना
करेक्ट, इसमें देखो क्या लिखा हुआ है, दे हैव गिवन द कंटीन्यूअस यूनिफॉर्म डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन से रिजल्ट 0,1. नाउ अगेन व्हाट आर द चेक्स व्हिच वी कैन परफॉर्म इसके ऊपर?
है। सेम बिटवीन 0 एंड 1 इट शुड बी, नॉट बी एनीथिंग।
ठीक है, सो दिस इज वन पार्ट ऑफ इट. और भी काफी, लाइक हमारे पास ये कितना डेटा है, 20 into 100 है फॉर 100 कैंडिडेट्स. करेक्ट, 20 into 100 है, तो वी हैव कितना कितना हुआ हमारे पास, कितना डेटा हुआ बताओ, इन टोटल 2000 हुआ.
हाँ
राइट, तो इन सबका मीन, वी हैव 2000 डेटा फ्रॉम यूनिफॉर्म 0,1, इन सबका
मीन
मीन 0.5, वेरियंस शुड बी 1/12, 1/12 होगा ना यूनिफॉर्म 0,1,
हाँ माइनस ए होगा,
या तो 1/12 होना चाहिए वेरियंस. एंड भी और हम लोग इसके ऊपर काई स्क्वायर भी सीखेंगे कल. मैं एक्स्ट्रा करवाऊंगी हर पेपर में ताकि आप लोग अकस्टम हो पाओ कि व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट वेज. सो दीज आर द चेक्स व्हिच वी हैव टू परफॉर्म, एंड इन सबके ऊपर मार्क्स है एंड सेल्फ चेक्स करेंगे. तो ये हो जाएगा हमारा वैलिडेशन वाला पोर्शन. एंड व्हाट आई वॉन्ट यू ऑल टू डू इज ओनली फॉर टुमारो, गो थ्रू द बैकग्राउंड डॉक्यूमेंट अगेन एक बार. डू नॉट स्टार्ट वर्किंग ऑन इट, हम लोग कल करेंगे उसको क्लास में, साथ में एवरी वन ऑफ अस विल डू. यू जस्ट हैव टू गो थ्रू द बैकग्राउंड एक बार, एंड दैट्स इट, देन वील टुमारो कंटिन्यू फ्रॉम हियर. सो इफ एनी वन ऑफ यू वॉन्ट टू आस्क एनी थिंग.
Tomorrow, when will be the class? This time only.
Let most probably in the afternoon time, we'll discuss that in the group. आई विल आस्क सबका सूटेबिलिटी जब होगा तब उसके अकॉर्डिंग विल टेक सो दैट्स नॉट एन इशू एनीथिंग एल्स
So, मतलब इस पर्टिकुलर पेपर में दे डोंट हैव एनी डॉक्यूमेंट्स राइट लाइक स्टडी मटेरियल जैसे बाकी सीटी पेपर्स में था सो दिस पेपर इज मोर ओवर लाइक जितना प्रैक्टिस करो दैट इज गुड राइट
करेक्ट करेक्ट सो टू थिंग्स ऑब्वियसली प्रैक्टिसिंग बट व्हाट आई बिलीव इज स्मार्टली प्रैक्टिसिंग क्योंकि खाली हम लोग खाली प्रैक्टिस करते जा रहे हैं वैसा भी नहीं वी नीड टू बिल्ड आवर ओन वे ऑफ डूइंग थिंग्स तो आई विल शो यू द इजिएस्ट वे क्योंकि अगर आप एक अप्रोच रखोगे पूरे जगह पे कि आपने चेक्स डाला तो आप उसको कलर कर रहे हो रेड से आपने मार्किंग किया येलो से कुछ तो तीन चार ऐसा फॉर्मेटिंग तीन चार तरीका ये अगर हम लोग बना के रखें तो एग्जाम में दिक्कत नहीं होगा बिकॉज द वे ऑफ प्रेजेंटेशन ऑल्सो मैटर्स यहाँ पे सो दीज आर द थिंग्स ऑल्सो टाइम बाउंड प्रैक्टिसिंग जो हम लोग को करना है सो ऑल ऑफ दीज थिंग्स विल ओनली हेल्प अस कोई एक्स्ट्रा मटीरियल इज नॉट देयर फॉर CP2 एज सच everything I covered in my PPT and when we move ahead, there will be pointers which I'll be adding to my PPT so that you all can keep in mind these small tips and tricks. Okay? Aise there is no material which you have to go through and you have to learn as such.
Okay, and adding the INI and IFOA, so which one is better? Like I haven't decided yet. Ki INI se dena hai ya IFO se dena hai?
मेरे लिए मैं अगर बोलूँ नॉट फ्रॉम द पर्सपेक्टिव ऑफ एग्जामिनेशन ईजी होगा या डिफिकल्ट मेरे लिए ऑलवेज IFOA क्यों क्योंकि दो दिन है लाइक पेपर वन एक दिन है नेक्स्ट डे यू हैव पेपर टू इन केस ऑफ IAI यू हैव इट ऑन द वेरी सेम डे तो अगर यू आर लाइक इन अ स्टेट की आप कंटिन्यूसली दो एग्जाम दे सकते हो पहले आपने 3 hours 15 minutes सो 15 minutes है तो ऑब्वियसली 15 minutes एक्स्ट्रा एक्सटेंड होगा इन ऑर्डर टू सबमिट एंड ऑल सो 3 hours 15 minutes का पहला पेपर देन मे बी 1-1.5 hours का जो आपको ब्रेक मिला एंड देन यू हैव 3 hours 15 minutes हाफ एन आवर एक्स्ट्रा फॉर द नेक्स्ट पेपर सो इफ यू हैव दिस कैपेसिटी कि आप पूरा दिन दे पाओ पेपर बिकॉज आपको पूरा दिन ही जाएगा ऑलमोस्ट तो आप गो फॉर IAI देर इज नो वे कि IAI ईजी है IFO ईजी है ऐसा बिल्कुल नहीं है ठीक है तो प्रैक्टिसिंग इज द की दोनों में क्योंकि और कुछ अलग से क्वेश्चंस नहीं मॉडल्स दोनों में आते हैं एंड वैसा नहीं कि एक में ईजी आते एक में डिफिकल्ट आते इट विल डिपेंड कि आपको उस समय मॉडल स्ट्राइक कर रहे कि नहीं सो अगेन फ्रॉम माई परस्पेक्टिव आई वुड सजेस्ट कि IFO इसे करो क्योंकि दो अलग अलग दिन है यू विल नॉट बी टायर्ड बिकॉज पेपर वन अगेन 3 hours 15 minutes के लिए बैठ के पेपर दे रहे हो तो इट इज टायरिंग ऑब्वियसली एंड फिर वापस यू आर सिटिंग फॉर द सेम एग्जामिनेशन सो इफ यू कैन टेक अप दैट यू कैन गो फॉर IAI एंड अगेन मार्च में है IAI से IFOA का अप्रैल एंड में सो 1 month का गैप है आपको 1 month एक्स्ट्रा मिल जाएगा इफ यू गो फॉर IFOA सो ऑल दीज पैरामीटर्स प्रोज एंड कॉन्स आप एक लिस्ट बना लो एंड देन यू डिसाइड कि आपको किससे देना है
मतलब वैसा कुछ नहीं है ना कि पेपर क्वालिटी लाइक IAI का ज्यादा टफ होता है कंपेयर टू IFO ऐसा नहीं है राइट
नो नो नॉट एट ऑल क्योंकि मॉडल है ना कि आप भाई मैं बोल रही हूँ कि हो सकता है IAI का उस टर्म में मॉडल ऐसा आया कि आपको स्ट्राइक कर गया और IFO का नहीं किया बट वाइस वर्सा भी हो सकता है सो दैट इज नॉट अ की पॉइंट ओवर हियर बस हाँ एक चीज है कि आपको समरी एंड ऑडिट ट्रेल वर्ड में नहीं लिख के आपको एक्सेल में ही लिखना होता है इन केस ऑफ IAI आपको वर्ड एक ही फाइल सबमिट करना है विच इज योर एक्सेल फाइल उसी में आपका ऑडिट ट्रेल जाएगा एंड सेकंड पेपर में समरी जाएगा इन केस ऑफ IFOA आपको दो फाइल सबमिट करनी होती है स्प्रेडशीट एंड योर वर्ड फाइल में आपका ऑडिट ट्रेल एंड समरी जाता है अलग से ओके सो यू मेक अ लिस्ट नो टुडे ओनली एंड डिसाइडेड टुडे इटसेल्फ Today or tomorrow, because then only and IAI ka I don't think ज़्यादा papers दिए हुए हैं for CP2 and CP3. In case of IAI, they remove the papers. They just keep it maybe 2-3 term का paper रखते हैं. Whereas in case of IFOA, you will get all the papers, all the past papers. IFOA में that is not the case. IAI में sorry that is not the case. CP3 का I'm sure, CP2 का I'm not sure. But I जहाँ तक I remember they keep only 2-3 terms ka paper in case of IAI. So you will not have many question papers to practice in case of IAI. That is there. Wo cheez ek aur hai. So yeah, make a list of pros and cons aapko jo bhi suitable lage and then you go for whichever institute you want to.
Okay.
यू कैन डिस्कस इट विथ मी ऑल्सो नो वैसा कोई दिक्कत नहीं है. मेरे अकॉर्डिंग मुझे IIFO इस चीज में बेटर लगता है बिकॉज एक दिन दो पेपर देना इज नॉट वॉट आई फील कम्फर्टेबल विथ. दैट्स इट. एनी मोर क्वेश्चन यू विल हैव? ओके सो आई बिलीव नो मोर क्वेश्चन. So, kal I will let you all know the timing and you just have to go through the model once again. Nothing else, we'll be doing it in class itself. Okay.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye.